In this view of things, nothing can be remote from us, either in time or space. Either the idea is entirely dissipated, or it exists as an actual present entity, and not as something that shall be in the future. For where there is no sequence in time, there can be no future. Similarly, where there is no space, there can be no conception of anything as being at a distance from us. When the elements of time and space are eliminated, all our ideas of things must necessarily be as subsisting in a universe here and an everlasting now. This is no doubt a highly abstract conception, but I would ask the student to endeavour to grasp it thoroughly, since it is of vital importance in the practical application of mental science, as will appear further on. The opposite conception is that of things expressing themselves through conditions of time and space, and thus establishing a variety of relations to other things, as of bulk, distance, and direction, or of sequence in time. These two conceptions are respectively in the conception of the abstract and the concrete, of the unconditioned and the conditioned, of the absolute and the relative. They are not opposed to each other in the sense of incompatibility, but are each the complement of the other, and the only reality is in the combination of the two. The error of the extreme idealist is in endeavouring to realise the absolute without the relative, and the error of the extreme materialist is in endeavouring to realise the relative without the absolute. On the one side, the mistake is in trying to realise an inside without an outside, and on the other, in trying to realise an outside without an inside.